of our hearts. One and that you deserve the lifting of our lives. And that is what we are presenting unto you. Please take and glorify yourself. In this few moments that we are going to be spending in your presence, we that are here and those that are connected to us right now all over the world, Father, have your way.
Amen.
Do the miraculous.
Amen.
Turn around every negative situation unto positive one that will glorify you.
Amen.
And that will cause us to rejoice.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, have your way.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have worship and pray.
Amen.
God bless you. Please be seated majestically. We're going to be talking about the wind of change. The wind of change. In the book of Acts chapter 2, 1 to 4. Acts chapter 2, 1 to 4. The very original time that the Holy Ghost was made manifest, being poured out on believers, happened to be in this place. And he manifested as the wind brushing into me the way. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord, in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a what? A rushing mighty wind. And it filled all the earth where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and they sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues. And the Spirit gave them utterance. The first manifestation of the Holy Spirit in the day of the Pentecost time, which we are still flowing in right now, have to be wind, mighty rushing wind, the wind of change. This happened to be the people that forsook Jesus Christ. They were not bold, they were timid. What made them to not become bold? The wind. The wind can change any negative situation to a positive one. And that is the wind of change. In the book of Mark chapter 14, I think verse 20 or 50 or so, 14:20, the Bible said that they all forsook Jesus Christ. Immediately they saw that the soldiers had come to arrest him, they forsook him. But these same people that forsook him, after the wind of change has blown upon them, in Acts chapter 2, verse 14, Acts 2:14, the Bible said that Peter and the 11, they stood up boldly and they said, "Ye men of Judah," you were bold. These people that did, they could not even stand to become few people. What has happened? The wind of change has blown. In any area of your life that you are not experiencing what you desire, this wind of change by the Holy Spirit we are going to be speaking through today will blow into your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. The wind blew so much that Peter and John, they took notice of them in the book of Acts chapter 14, verse 13. Acts 14, 13. The Bible said that when they saw their boldness, they said that these people did not really go to any school. And they took notice of them that they must have been with Jesus. But not just with Jesus. They have been with Jesus all this while before. But what actually happened that they did not record for us happened to be the wind blew before that manifestation. Even though the Holy Ghost will blow upon your life.
Amen.
Many people all over the world, they are looking for change. Marital change, financial change, change in their health. But I'm putting to you today that if they can be consistent in speaking in tongues, I don't know how it will happen, but it will happen because that is the power of the Holy Ghost at play. It's better than what any doctor, anybody can do for you. The wind of change. Once it blows, it changes situation. Many people are in dead places. Dead places in the sense that some areas of their life, they are dead. Nothing is happening. But the desire, they change. But how will they get that change? They are only scattered. They are looking for people. People are actually on there. They are trying to help them. But some of this help cannot be gotten from anyone. But the wind that will change the situation. At a particular time, the prophet Ezekiel, he saw a valley of dry bones, dead situation. Situation that he did not even have confidence to say things will change. But in the book of Ezekiel chapter 37, 9 and 10, Ezekiel 37, 9 and 10, the Bible says that when the wind came to play, that which he did not even know that could actually manifest positively started manifesting gloriously. Then said he unto me, prophesy unto the wind. Prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus saith the Lord God, come from the four winds, O bread, and breathe upon this thing, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the bread came unto them, and they lived and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. You want change in your life? You want change in any area of your life that is not really manifesting gloriously? This is how to do it. Take time on a daily basis to speak in tongues. You are going to be seeing what is going to be happening in this church, this parish. For some time now, we have been doing something. It appears as if, but you will start seeing the glory that has been explained before is going to be like child's play compared to what we are going to be. Because it's not possible for you to consistently be blasting in tongues day after day that you remain the same on the same level. Things will just be happening anyhow. Let's start to pray and pray and say, Father, as I open my mouth, fill my mouth with divine utterance to bring changes in the area that I need changes, and also my brethren all over the world in the name of Jesus. Maleke shende lebele kete mama. Reke tele baba 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 baka tele lebele kete kuba. Ya baba 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 baka tele lebele. Meleke shende lebele ba. Lebele kete shende le baba baba baba. Ya baba baba baka tele lebele kete kuba. Lebele kete shende lebele ba. Ya baba 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 baka tele lebele kuba. Ya baba 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 baka tele ba. Lebele kete tele lebele kete kuba ba. Ya baba baba baka tele ba. Ya lebele kete tele lebele kete kuba. Against your family, in which struck them. God said that the hero that you need for your home and for your life to receive that which has been denied you, that hero has been sent for. God said, as you tell somebody here, like palm tree, you are going to become extremely productive. From outside, don't begin to bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Appreciate it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Dear my last father, we thank you for just this few moments that we have used to move by your Spirit to usher in the wind of change into our life and the life of our brethren that are watching all over the world. Father, you are not a liar. You are not a man that you should lie. Therefore, by the reading of this few moments, let there be growth, great changes in our life. Yeah. In the area that we have been feeling frustration, stagnation, and things are not working well, from now on, let them start working excellently well. Yeah. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Yeah. Our brethren are online, just like we normally tell them, God bless them. So you just wave to them on the camera and just say, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you very much.